Hi everyone, and welcome to another session of On Gear How To with me, Mike Else. Today's topic is profiles, and to be a little bit more specific, it is about the query builder within profiles. Have a look at one of our other videos where we talk about some of the other features that falls within the profiles sphere. But today, it is all about query builders. And the main function of query builders are that we can minimize or select the specific data that we want to see in any dashboard. Imagine you are coming in onto your work order dashboard and you see thousands and thousands of work orders because there's no filter in place. It will frustrate you absolutely endlessly. So typically we make use of the query builder and the filters to ensure we only see the records that we want to see. A very typical and standard profile or filter that we'll have in place is to see only our open work orders. And then maybe as we look at our work management process, we will start adding in different profiles and query builders and filters to ensure we see different sets of records as we work through the work management process. Typically, if there's new work orders that comes into the system, we want to see only awaiting approval status work orders, and we can apply a filter for that. Maybe we are currently just looking at breakdowns and we want to see where's the top breakdowns that we need to sort out and get fixed, and we can filter on only the breakdown work orders. Perhaps we only want to see all the work orders that is due within the next week. Then we can set up a filter so we can only see those records. So in short, query builder and filter is there to help us focus on that's important and exactly the task we want to perform right now. All right, let's head over to Anki and have a quick look how we can do that. So I'm standing here on my work order dashboard. I'm seeing a whole bunch of records and I'm going to go to my query builder. Right, and then under filter criteria, you can see there's already a bit of a filter in. We'll just delete that for now and we'll come back to that. Okay, let's start from scratch and add a new filter. First off, we need to add the criteria. So exactly what field do we want to filter? So let's start with something easy. Let's go to type of work and we say the type of work description needs to be equal to, there's some other operators we can select as well. In this case, it's very specific. It needs to be one type of work, and then we can type in the value. Right. So again, type of work description is equal to breakdown. That little radio button means it's on or it is off. So let's just make sure this filter is on, and then we can say run. And then we see only breakdown work orders. You can see here in the type of work column, only breakdowns. Right. We can go back to the query filter, filter criteria, and we can then say, all right, I want to see all the required by dates. Let's say required by, except is greater than or equal. And then I can use my date picker. Let's see if that gives us something. Then again, we just say run. Right, now we've reduced our amount of work orders that we are seeing even further. Right, now there's an additional feature we can do if we go back to the filter criteria. This date, you know, we didn't always want to come into the query builder to edit our date. We can change this value to not just be text, but we want to make it a parameter. I'm going to call this parameter name greater than, and the default value will just always be, let's say that, right, and accept. And you can see what it does. It grays that out because now we have created a parameter, and this parameter will be prompted to the user every time they open up this profile. You see here under parameters, there will be a full list of all the parameters that is in use. Now, if I say run, I get this little pop-up, work order required by greater than or equal to, and then I can just fill in my date, say continue, and that's it. So if we make that our default, every time we come into the work order dashboard, we'll be presented with that, and we can immediately say we want that those dates. Just do another example with that. I think this is a really, really powerful feature. Let's switch that off quickly. Let's change our breakdown one also to a parameter. I'm going to call it type of work so that we know what we're putting in. And default, I'm just going to say preventive. Right, let's say run. Right, so there it gives us our name, type of work I need to enter, but I'm looking only for breakdown. And continue, and then we'll get only breakdowns. This is a really cool feature that we can make as default for anyone that goes into a specific screen, and we want to prompt them immediately to help them sort and filter a little bit so they don't get overwhelmed with a amount of records. Of course, after you've built your query builder, you can go to profiles, you can save your profile and make it a default and add it to your operational roles. Like I mentioned, have a look at some of our other videos where we go into those details. Now, one other feature, we don't just have to do that on dashboards, but typically we can make that part of lookups as well. So let's say I'm busy planning my work order, and then I am responsible to allocate electricians to work orders. So let's go here to a lookup. Again, this is a typical dashboard, but here I can also add in a query builder specifying I only want to see staff members that has their default trade as electrician. Right, so it says default resource trade code is equal to, I know the code is ELC, and then I'll get a reduced list. And from here, again, we can save it as a profile and we can make it default for specific users. Right, in short, that is what we can do with the query builder. Maybe one additional thing in the help file, you can look for this page as well, add filter criteria. And there's a very nice link on key query language that will take you to a little bit more detail in how the query language has been put together and how you can use that to create all kinds of filters. This is a little bit more for the super user, this query language part, but if you're interested in delving, that's where you need to go. Oh yeah, excellent. Thanks for joining me today, and thanks for using Onkey.